Hello, everybody. Marty Richards and Richland Center Tourism here today, and we are wishing you a happy St. Patrick's Day. There's a lot of Irish-themed foods available in our greater Richland area. Feel free to go to richlandcentertourism.com, and you can see a listing under the dining tab of all of the different options that are available for you to choose from here in the area. There's quite a few of them. You can make a little tour out of it even if you wanted to and have a pretty good time. So today, of course, for our Why Do We Call It That episode, we have that theme of why do we call it, number one, St. Patrick's Day. And then right here in Westford Township, we have St. Bridget's Road. And so we're going to do a little double duty with a why do we call it St. Bridget's Road. So first off, why do we call it St. Patrick's Day? Well, St. Patrick, of course, a long time ago lived in Ireland, but really his story starts, he was English, born in Britain, and then he was actually taken into slavery, taken to Ireland, and then once he escaped from his slavery, or he fulfilled his servitude that he had to fulfill, he then became a priest. Now, it's real interesting about St. Patrick in that he has never actually been formally canonized or actually recognized by the Catholic Church as a saint. Also interesting, his real claim to fame, of course, he's known as the bringer of faith and the banisher of snakes from Ireland. Now, the bringer of faith is true. He is credited primarily with being literally the first person to bring Christianity to Ireland, but not necessarily Catholicism. So he was very much instrumental in bringing Christianity to the country, maybe not so much Catholicism in itself. While it is true, following his time in Ireland, there were no snakes, it's also true there were never snakes prior to him living in Ireland. So that one's a little bit of legend. He actually is not responsible for banishing snakes. So that's why we, and really the St. Patrick's Day celebration was brought on in the 1600s in Ireland by the Catholic Church to celebrate as a feast celebration in the end of winter, beginning of springtime, hence why green or the bringing of the green. And then also the shamrock. The Catholic Church always had also botanical symbols that go along with their saints and with their important individuals, and the shamrock was the one that was assigned, so that all works perfectly well. The feast of St. Patrick wasn't started until about 12 centuries after he had existed as well. Now, one little disclaimer here. I am not Catholic, and I have not done any Catholic studies. I was raised Methodist, so really I'm qualified, quite honestly, just to help you set up a committee to decide various different things, or talk about setting up and studying various things in committees. So my apologies to those Catholic theologians and those who have really studied these. If I miss by a little bit, I apologize. But I do know that I have done a little bit of study on it and some research, and so I'm somewhere close to the vein of truth that does exist. Now, St. Bridget's, very important to discuss her as well. Number one, this is actually spelled incorrectly, and it's more of a time-lapse thing. So when St. Bridget, without the T, was on Earth, and there's question about that, if she really was an individual, or was she a compilation of different stories that occurred through time? Now, the Historical Catholic Review has argued, and I think most people accept through that, that yes, St. Bridget was an actual individual. She has actually formally been recognized as a saint and canonized through the Catholic Church. She was extremely important in Ireland to bringing modern-day Catholic life for men and women and understanding how to celebrate that and how to worship that. Now, she has quite a story where when she was born, her mother was actually baptized, it alleges, that she was actually baptized by St. Patrick, but shortly thereafter, her mother also ended up in slavery and served out her servitude while she was in slavery. St. Bridget was born and was actually raised or attempted to be raised by some Druids. Now, because they were unclean, how the story goes, that they would offer food. She was unable to eat it. She was, you know, made ill by the food offered by them. And then at that point in time, a cow with red eyes appeared and then gave sustenance to St. Bridget. She was then raised, received by the Catholic Church as very important. She went on, as I said, to then make daily Catholic life for men and women, how to carry that on, very important. She also was a creator or started two different monastic institutions, one very important in Kildare, Ireland, very well recognized. She also was very important in formation of schools that taught many different things, the arts, leather craft, smith's work. So she really did a lot of things in her time. Again, a little bit of an argument if she was a real individual or a compilation of several people that did several things. But again, through the Catholic Church, they do recognize her as an actual individual. And here on St. Bridget's Road, we're right in the hub of where in the mid-1850s to 1860s, many Irish people settled this area. Even if you look my shoulder behind me, you can maybe faintly make out the town of Bunker Hill. And if you go back to our Bunker Hill episode, you'll remember we talked about how the Irish did settle the area, and Bunker Hill was even named after an area they came from the east, you guessed it, in Bunker Hill, from Revolutionary War fame, that this area looks a little bit like that. So if you get the chance to come check out this area, as you can tell, there's a really cool ATV, UTV road trail that goes through here. Just beautiful scenery. You know, we're in that kind of caught between our different variations of weather, with winter and spring kind of re-emerging every now and then. Today, a beautiful day. So it would be a great day to go out on a UTV, ATV ride. Tomorrow, who knows, we could get four inches of snow. But the good news at this time of year, that usually doesn't last. So we put our shovels away. It melts on its own. We don't need to worry about it. At least that's what I'm selling. So we hope you have a fantastic St. Patrick's Day. Get to go out there, celebrate a little bit, carefully and responsibly, of course. But make sure you get some corned beef, also a Reuben, or cabbage and potatoes. A lot of different offerings in the area to enjoy that. And when you're enjoying that, you can think over where you sit on the St. Bridget without the T and St. Patrick debate of were they real people or not, or did St. Patrick really drive snakes out of Ireland or not? That's real questionable. So that's why we call it St. Patrick's Day, and that's why we call this St. Bridget's Road. For Richland Center Tourism, I'm Marty Richards. Have a fantastic day.